Hello students, in today's video, I will be explaining about the cultural contribution of Chalukyas. Before going into the video, if anyone is seeing the channel without subscribing, please do subscribe to my channel and share it with your friends. It will be of a great encouragement for me. And also click the bell button to receive notifications whenever I upload new videos. So without wasting time, let us get into the video. Cultural contribution of Chalukyas. So in the last two videos, we have seen about the important rulers of Chalukyas, their achievements and all those things. So now let us see about their cultural contributions. First, let us see about their religion. The kings were tolerant towards all religion. The Chalukyan kings, they were tolerant towards all religion. They were staunch devotees of Vishnu, but they patronized Shaivism, Jainism and Buddhism. So although they were staunch or strong worshippers of Lord Vishnu, they patronized or encouraged Shaivism, Jainism and Buddhism. Their religious tolerance can be seen in the cave temples of Badami. So we can see how they encouraged all religion. The best example is the cave temples of Badami. I will be explaining that in more detail in this video only. They also patronized priests and respected them. So the kings, they patronized priests and they also respected them. According to Huan Zhang, Buddhism also existed during Chalukyan period. So other than Hinduism, Buddhism also existed during this period. So the Chalukyan rulers were tolerant towards all religion. They were staunch devotees of Vishnu, but they patronized Shaivism, Jainism and Buddhism. Their religious tolerance can be seen in the cave temples of Badami. They also patronized or they encouraged priests and respected them. According to Huan Zhang, that is Chinese traveler, Buddhism also existed during this period. So all these were about their religion. Now let us see about the literature during Chalukyan time. The rulers of Chalukyas of Badami gave patronage to many scholars. So they also encouraged many scholars. Many inscriptions in Kannada and Sanskrit have been composed during this time. So the inscriptions during that time was written in two languages, mainly Kannada and in Sanskrit. Mahakuta pillar inscription describes the achievement of Kirti Varman I. So one of the most important inscription is the Mahakuta pillar inscription. It describes the achievements of Kirti Varman I. Kaumudi Mahotsava was a work written by Vijaya Bhattarika. So another important work was Kaumudi Mahotsava. It was written by Vijaya Bhattarika. She was a daughter-in-law of Pulikeshi II. Devikirti was a court poet of Pulikeshi II and he composed the very famous I Hole inscription. So Pulikeshi II court poet Devikirti, he composed I Hole inscription. It tells about the achievements of Pulikeshi II, that is why it is also called as I Hole Prashasti. Another literary development of the Chalukyas was the Badami inscription of Pulikeshi I. So there were many inscriptions that was written in Sanskrit as well as Kannada. Mahakuta pillar inscription, it describes the achievements of Kirti Varman I. Kaumudi Mahotsava, written by Vijaya Bhattarika, is another important work. Devikirti, who was a court poet of Pulikeshi II, composed I Hole inscription, also known as I Hole Prashasti. Another literary development was a Badami inscription of Pulikeshi I. So all these were the main contributions in literature during the Chalukyan period. Now let us see the most important contribution of Chalukyas, that is art and architecture. The Chalukyas of Badami have given marvelous contribution to Indian art and architecture. So the contributions given by Chalukyas of Badami to art and architecture is marvelous. One of the unique contribution was building of Stambha Mandapa or Navaranga and Sukhanashi along with Garbhagriha. So one of the speciality of Chalukyan architecture, if we see, is the Stambha Mandapa, or it is called as the Navaranga and Sukhanasi along with Garbhagriha. Many of their temples were built using Nagara or North Indian style and Dravida or South Indian style. So we can see a mix of two different styles, that is Nagara style or North Indian style and Dravida style or South Indian style. Red sandstone was used for construction. The material which was used for construction was red sandstone. Small models of temples were built, and the main temple was built based on that. So before construction of the main temple, a small model of the temple was built, and based on this model, the main temple was made. Percy Brown had called their architecture as the cradle of Indian temple architecture. So according to Percy Brown, Chalukyan architecture can be called as the cradle of Indian temple architecture, which means it can be said as a birthplace of Indian temple architecture. The main centers of their art are Badami, Aihole, Pottadakallu. So we can see a lot of examples of Chalukyan art in places like Badami, Aihole and Pottadakallu. So the Chalukyas of Badami gave a marvelous contribution to Indian art and architecture. One of their unique contribution was building of Stambha Mantapa or Navaranga and Sukhanasi along with Garbhagriha. Many of their temples were built using Nagara or North Indian style and Dravida or South Indian style. Red sandstone was used for construction. Before building the main temple, they made a small model of the temple, and based on that, the main temple was built. According to Percy Brown, the Chalukyan architecture can be said as a cradle of Indian temple architecture, and the main centers of their art are Badami, Aihole and Pattadakallu. Now let us see the important characteristic features of Chalukyan architecture. What makes Chalukyan architecture different? What are its characteristic features? Small base design. If you observe most of the temples made during Chalukyan age, one of the common feature you can see is small base design. The second one, horseshoe base. The base will be in the shape of horseshoe. So horseshoe shaped base. Square Garbhagriha. The Garbhagriha will be in square shape. Inner Pradakshina Patha. There will be a Pradakshina Patha inside the temple. The fifth feature is Mukhamandapa, Navaranga, Sukhanasi and pyramidical shape Shikhara on the Garbhagriha. We have already seen that Navaranga and Sukhanasi was one of the important feature of their temple, and the Shikhara or the top portion will be pyramidical shape. And the last point is the temples were Ekakuta temple, Dvikuta temple or Trikuta temple. There will be temples dedicated to one god, or there will be more than one god worshipped in the temple. So Ekakuta, Dvikuta and Trikuta temples were there. So the main characteristic features of Chalukyan architecture, that is small base design, horseshoe shaped base, square Garbhagriha, Inner Pradakshina Patha, Mukhamandapa, Navaranga, Sukhanasi, and the Shikhara will be pyramidical shape Shikhara. Then Ekakuta, Dvikuta and Trikuta temples will be made. The temples made will be Ekakuta, Dvikuta or Trikuta temples. That is a temple. Ekakuta means there will be a single shrine, Dvikuta two shrines and Trikuta three shrine temples. So first let us see in detail about the cave temples of Badami. This is one of the most important example of Chalukyan architecture. Four rock cut cave temples were built at Badami. So Badami was known for or famous for rock cut temples or cave temples. There were four rock cut cave temples at Badami. Cave number one belongs to Shaivism. And how do we understand that? We understand that because the sculptures of Ardhanarishvara and Nataraja here are very attractive. So first cave, cave number one, belongs to Shaivism, where we find sculptures of Ardhanarishvara and Nataraja. Cave number two and three belongs to Vaishnavism. Varaha and Vamana bas reliefs are found in cave number 2. So cave number 2 and 3 belongs to Vaishnavism, where we find Varaha and Vamana bas reliefs in cave number 2. Cave number 3 is the biggest of all and was built by Mangalesha. Both cave 2 and 3 belongs to Vaishnavism, and in that cave number 3 is the biggest and it was built by Mangalesha. The sculptures of the earth goddess Vishnu sitting on Shesha and Narasimha, Balarama, Vamana, Harihara, all are found in cave number 3, and all of them are very attractive sculptures. So in cave number 3 we have sculptures of earth goddess Vishnu sitting on Shesha and Narasimha, Balarama, Vamana, Harihara, all are very attractive sculptures in cave number 3, and it is the biggest. The smallest is cave number 4, which is a Jain cave. So this is what we studied when we said about the religion of Chalukyas. They were tolerant towards all religion, and we said that it can be seen in the cave temples of Badami. So the smallest cave is cave number 4, which is a Jain cave. Here we can see the sculpture of Mahavira and his disciple Gautama, Parshvanatha. All these sculptures we can see in cave number 4. So cave number 4 is the smallest cave, where we can see sculptures of Mahavira, then his disciple Gautama, Parshvanatha, the 23rd Tirthankara. All these sculptures we can see in cave number 4. Later, the above Basadi came to be called as Melana or Mena Basadi. The Jain Basadi came to be called as Melana or Mena Basadi. Other than cave temples in Badami, we can also see some artistic temples like Bhutanatha temple, Lakumisha temple, Virupaksha temple, etc. So other than these cave temples, we can see some artistic temples like Bhutanatha temple, Lakumisha temple and Virupaksha temple. So Chalukya contribution in architecture, the cave temples of Badami are very important. There are four rock cut cave temples. In that, the cave number 1 belongs to Shaivism, cave number 2 and 3 belongs to Vaishnavism, and cave number 3 is the biggest of all and was built by Mangalesha. Smallest is cave number 4, which is a Jain cave. Here we can see sculptures of Mahavira, Gautama, Parshvanatha, etc. And this above Basadi later came to be called as Melana or Mena Basadi. Other than cave temples, we can also see some artistic temples like Bhutanatha temple, Lakumisha temple and Virupaksha temple. So in today's video we have seen about the religion of Chalukyas, then we saw about the literature, and we have seen about some points regarding the art and architecture, and one example we have seen, that is cave temples of Badami. There are few more examples coming which will be explained in the coming videos. So I hope you have understood all the points explained in today's video, and if you have liked the video, please don't forget to like, share and subscribe to my channel. I hope to see you all soon in the next video. Thank you for watching.